How are you, people? Glad you're here. Pull up a chair, sit a while. Welcome, new subscribers. I forget to do that. Thanks for the wonderful comments. I appreciate this. I don't have as much time as I used to answer them. I try to get them where I can. What we have today is, as you know, like the saw here, that's the 86cc with a pipe on it that we ran. Unported. We're continuing on with this type of build for just a little bit, but I can't mess around long. We've got some 046 steels to build, two of them, one for Sawfest for raffle, and one for Kevin Z. And Kevin Z is going to be at Buckin Stock Sawfest. Sawfest is October 13th. And 14th in Marysville, Ohio. Okay? There's a whole bunch of motels and stuff out there. I suggest if you're going to try to go and get one, you better get it fairly soon, because the closer you get, the more expensive they are. We've had ours booked for quite a while. Colin did it for us. Okay, what I'm doing, about a year ago, I think, I had sent a test saw to Buckin Billy, just kind of a, I was wanting to try three things. It wasn't about horsepower as much as using ceramic hybrid bearings, New West crankshafts from Wolf Creek Saw Shop, thank you Ryan, and seeing what fairly, I mean, might as well say extremely high compression does. I left the port numbers fairly, I mean, they're just tiny, a little bit of scrub here and there, but fairly stock saw. And I want to see where the failure is, because I know what's hard on bearings, and I know what's hard on cranks, where it was testing. Well, we finally got it, where something finally broke. It wasn't anything that I thought. I have the saw here. He sent it back, because we're going to build this potentially as a 94cc saw. It may be an 88 with a long rod, or it might be 88 with a stock rod. I'm not going to know until I put that crankshaft back together. We've already got it stroked. It's in the process as we speak of being bored 1 millimeter longer, which is a 2 millimeter up and down. So we're going to have 38 millimeter stroke, 56 millimeter bore, and a 372 if this works out. We don't know yet, do we? But we're going to find out right here. I think it'll work. Maybe. Hardest part was getting a 390 cylinder on this freaking saw behind me that's got the pipe on it. That was the hardest thing. Let's get this box open and see what we have to work with. I'm going to go ahead and do all the cutting, because I will tell you, Buck and Billy Smith really pack something. Get an axe from him, you'll know what I'm talking about. Well, it wasn't as bad to open as what I've been physically challenged on receiving something from Buckin Billy. Sometimes you got to use the old thing that works, the Harvey Drake rip and tear method. Let's call it the Iron Horse rip and tear method now, huh? Okay. There it is. It came back. There's Wolf Creek. It's not going to be long. We're going to need these for fire starters. I need more of them, guys. Well, actually don't, but that's what I use them for. Outrageously good job. This is a Buckin come up with a container. It's got nuts and bolts and hardware. That worked. Okay, here's the cylinder. Nice and protected. When he packs something, he really packs it. Side cover. dogs. Pretty crazy. Okay. When you're shipping saws anywhere, do this. Take your gas oil out. Rinse your oil tank with some chainsaw gas or regular gas or whatever. Put a paper towel in each tank. Put the lid on. Put it in a garbage bag. Seal it up just like this. You will not have trouble shipping your saw. But do that. Well, this one had a bit of an oil leak. See, this is why you put them in garbage bags. A little bar oil. It's definitely bar oil. Darn near bled to death. Okay. I gotta get rid of this slippery old bag. He told me that this saw broke a ring. It run really good. Other than the compression was a bit much. In stock timing numbers, they're only going to do so much. They really are. What this one actually is, it's a 272 piston that I machined. Yeah, you get a pop-up, and then you pop her up just a bit more. Well, with a lower exhaust, it's 104, 105, something like that. Yeah, just terrible, terrible compression. It's just awful. Okay. Well, crank feels good. This is a good candidate. Now, here's how I'm going to handle this, because I can run this crank in it. It's already got ceramic hybrid bearings in it. We need that. Okay. I can run this crank. I really can. But I don't want to pull it apart until I get the stroked crank all the way together and get it between my parallels. And we'll know then. We'll know then. I should show you some of that while assembling a crank and truing it, what you deal with. Is that interesting? If it's not, we don't worry about little things like that. Nothing wrong with showing method, okay? So the first thing I have to do is make the cylinder, in this case, fit down inside the saw, okay? Right here, in this area here, and here, that may be a bit small. Now, I want to thank somebody publicly. Dino Joe, thank you. Thank you so much for the work you did. Joe did the channel and me a nice, nice job. He bored this and sleeved it to 56 millimeter, okay? He did. Now, if you want to see what you start with, that 372 is no slouch. It's 5.5 horse right out of the box. You know that, guys, XPs. There's the piston, okay? That's the piston. Right around here somewhere. This is the piston we're using. There's a little bit of a difference. Where you get to laughing is when you see a 50 millimeter piston go in that big of a bore. It just rattles around in there. Yeah. So that is all the way to the same bore as the 394 or 395 Husky. Joe, fantastic work. Just fantastic. But now, I got to see. Now, yeah, I don't even have to take the rings off. This is big bore, by the way. This is 52 millimeter. I can just slop her on there. You know something? Everything but goes on. Everything but go on. If I took another 10,000ths, I took 20,000ths off, that would fit. I had Joe keep this fairly thin, and we're going to find out if that was a good idea or not. But I think it was. I think we're going to be happy with us. I really do. I might as well show you what some of the things you deal with. I could recommend this build right now as 86cc right here. That's stock crank. Ain't got to screw with it. Now, obviously being unported, we have, I would consider acceptable performance right now, really. And if once I show you what I'm fixing to show you, you'd be surprised to run as good as it does. Which it isn't bad. I would run that logging just the way it is. So, let me get this off the bench. Got to clear its case. It'd take 25,000ths all the way around. But this is the fun part. This is the real fun part for me. I've done so many. I mean, an unbelievable amount of these 372s over the years since the 371 come out. They were about 2 years old. I was getting the 371s, obviously, from loggers as they wear them out. And at first, we just rebuilding them, and we was playing with them. And then we got worse playing with them hard and found out where they start blowing up and backed off just a little bit. And they lived. And they lived good. But let me get set up here. I've got the camera moved, and we're going to spend a few minutes together. I'm going to give you just about enough information that you can build an 86cc version of this. It doesn't run hot. It idles good, starts good, the whole nine yards. But I'm going to show you the rest of the story. You wanted that. You asked, I'm going to give it to you. Okay. This is a 372 big bore, 52 millimeter bore. This is 372 gasket. You can see here your primary and secondary transfers and how they line up with the gasket. Obviously, the bolt holes line up. Okay. Now, something you need to know, if you're going to run this as a 55 millimeter bore, this is a stock 390 cylinder, that these are really quite thick here. It would be nice if you can get somebody to take half of this material off the outside in a lathe for you. Don't try to do that with something else. It's not going to work. Otherwise, you're going to really butcher your cases to get this to fit down in them. Which, that's what I did on this 86cc build. So obviously, this gasket is not going to fit over, see? It's just not going to. Okay? But with what Joe did for me, this is what we end up with. He left that considerable thinner. That gasket goes right over it nice. Now, if you notice, you've seen how that gasket fit in where the primary and secondary transfers was. This is the approximate position. We have to take a Sharpie on every one of these holes and mark out where they go. The best thing you could do is turn a piece of aluminum in a lathe and plug the original holes, relocate center, and bore them. I'm not going to do that because I don't have the aluminum here, and I'm not going to drive 25 miles just to get a little chunk. Should have got it yesterday. But here's what's important. They did a good job with the primary or the secondary transfer, which is next to the intake. But if you notice, this is smaller. See that gasket? That's smaller than a 372. They're not as big this way either, from here to here. They're not as big. And to represent that, I'll put that back on, and you'll see what I'm talking about. See? That's big. That's open, isn't it? Okay, you see? Quite a bit of material to take out everywhere. It's bigger this way, still fits on the case. It seals just fine. There's plenty of room to seal without a gasket. You would have to get a 390 gasket and do a bunch of trimming and pray like crazy if you were going to try to use a gasket. I recommend Motor Seal, I swear to God. And you'll see why in a minute. Now, if you are going to run the stock cylinder and you're going to try this, what you need to know is your timing on your intake is way to crap off. You're going to have to fill the bottom, which is the top here, about a third to halfway full of JB Weld. And I can show you how to do that. It's just a piece of sandboard, but sandpaper, but in fact, I think I use this on one. The foam that comes in these pistons that retain them, grease your paper, use a little, just like a soda pop box, cardboard, and just roll it in here, but grease that paper first, so it blocks your intake. Take that foam, hold it in there before you put your JB Weld. You know, press that right in good, and you can fill your intake. But don't have it upside down like this one. Have it right side up. And then you can go in there with sandpaper and just lightly sand. You want to make sure your JB Weld does not come in contact with the piston, but it runs fairly close. Then you got to start hitting your timing numbers. That's what you got to do. That's the only real problem that I had with this build. I know some of you guys out there are more than capable of doing it, and I want to help you have as much fun as I do. That's what I want, okay? But when you can openly see together, this is 372, and this is 390. The 372 actually has a bigger transfer. But we're going to fix all this, okay? We're going to fix it. Now, when you realize that that 86cc, I have not altered the transfers, and there's that much hanging up here, and it's a little bit of a mismatch right here on this side in the case. Just a little bit of a mismatch here, but it's definitely not big here. The flow characteristics were insanely horrible, just insanely horrible. For the saw to even run and pull chain at all was just dumbfounding to me. Actually, the first cylinder I put on, I was dumbfounded it even started. Okay, because we use such advanced tools, I'm going to use my Sharpie. Yes, there's better ways to do this. Line that big gasket up with your surfaces. There's better ways. I try to show you guys how to do things with just a minimum, okay? That's what I try to do. You know, I know there's a lot of issues that crop up that seem hard to solve, but they're not. You just got to think about it. The one hole almost wants to line up. We catch a lot of heat, a lot of us support from other YouTubers. I think it's ridiculous. I'm not going to name names because they don't matter in my world. They really don't. They do not count to me one bit. There are a lot of jaw flappers out there. I just don't believe in bad mouthing everybody. This is a sport. It's a hobby. It's fun. The comments of, oh, you're cutting rotten wood. Oh, that saw runs terrible. Oh, my wood's harder than your wood. What are you doing? Freaking see you freaking pee higher up the fence post? Is that what you want? Well, you know what? You meet these people that talk smack, other channels, in public, they're a lot nicer. Yeah. I'll tell you why. I got one philosophy. They always want to walk up and shake your hand. Hey, go get your freaking saw. Come on. I don't want to talk about it. So you pay for that few years of wanting to talk smack to everybody out there on YouTube to try to justify your own existence. You don't have to do that for me. I freely share everything I do here. Good, bad, ugly, indecent, proper, does not matter. Okay. Now, by tracing that out, the gasket, you can see where I'm at with the bowls. You know, they're all over the map. You can see why I recommend just turning a aluminum plug, putting it in there, and just facing it. And then do a proper layout. I'm not going to do that on this one. I'm not going to worry about it. It's not a big deal anyway. But most importantly, from where the gasket is, see how much is there? This is just slightly this way more than the 372, which you need because you've got a much bigger bore. But you really need more transfer here. And these are not wide enough. They're not. And Joe did some holes for me, so I can go in there and trace them out. I started on my exhaust. I'm going to sneak up on the intake because I'm going to use the sleeve. If I need to put a little JB Weld in, I'm going to use the sleeve to butt up against the fill. Okay, that's what I'm going to do. And then we finish it off. But this is kind of the gist of what's going on with us. I hope I'm helping you. Now, something that can be done, and I had a good friend ask me the other day, Harv, can I use a 390 intake boot on a 372 because I want to put the 390 carb on it? No, can't do it because the 390 is bigger OD than the 372. Something interesting though with this build, you can stretch out that intake boot of a 372 and get it on a 390, but your clamp's going to be at the last freaking thread. You're going to have to figure all that out. Yeah, it's just like this, just greasy old hog, you know. It'll go. Because 390 intake boots are not cheap. They're not. 372s are easy to be had. I will be running a 395 carburetor on this combination, no matter what it is. That's what I've got on the 86cc. We got to port that. I want to take that this one right here to Sawfest. This is what I want to do. And I'm going to tell you more about that in just a second. Now, if you do the 86 CC build, I showed you the transfers, what you got to do. This is a steel MS661 with a pop-up from Highway. Thanks, Ryan. Ryan's a good guy at Wolf Creek Saw Shop. That's who I'm talking about. It seems like it was 40 to 42 thousandths. I'd have to look at my book. To get this to have proper squish with no base gasket. Okay, I have two choices to look at here. I had to take 1 millimeter off the OD in my little precision lathe. If you don't have the ability to do that yourself, you go find somebody in a machine shop that has the proper lathe to do that for you. Because 390s are 55 millimeter. Okay? We went to 56 millimeter, the same as this piston. It saves machining. Now, 1 millimeter is only half a millimeter per side. That's not that much, but it is a weight reduction without sacrificing strength. Now, with a 2 millimeter longer stroke, this changes. What I've got to do, which is you actually only move that pin 1 millimeter. I have got to take approximately 80 thousandths off the top of that. That leaves me like 55 thousandths from that ring land. Now, 55 thousandths is just that big. Okay, how do I handle that? Well, I'll tell you what I had to do. I had to take a sanding disc, and you're going to have to do this with an 6cc build when you turn this piston down. You either take the pin out that locates the rings, or you take and thin your ring. Work very slowly with this, guys, and don't do it unless you're in the mood. You can go around this ring. Don't build a lot of heat. Just kiss it with your little Dremel or your Ford or whatever you have. Take about around 20 thousandths off the inside of this ring. But do it nice and evenly. Just be gentle, okay? In this saw, I'm going to do the same thing even though I don't have to, because it creates a lower tension rings. Those of you that drag race, little track, performance engines know the advantage of having low tension rings. You know it. You do. As long as it ain't too low, right? Yeah, we've done that one. Okay. Now, by having a low tension ring, even though this ring land is going to be fairly thin, yes, the dome will be substantial. Yes, I know. We're going to take some of that off. It's going to be too much. This is a work saw. This ain't a race saw. It's not a cookie cutter. I don't build cookie cutters. I mean, what do you do with that? Okay, so low tension rings equal less parasitic drag, meaning the ring isn't dragging up and down on the piston. It's minimal. It's not a big deal, but it's less wear over time. It is. So 20 thousandths. So measure your brand new ring. I recommend Kaber. Just take 20 thousandths. If you go a little over, you need 20. I warn you that. You need 20 on a 55 millimeter. On this, I could do 10, 15 if I wanted. But I need less tension up here so that I don't, when that piston goes down so violently, that it don't bust this ring land off, which it can. It can. There's a little things that's going to keep this saw together that I'm building right now for Buck and Billy. And I'll tell you what some of them are. You got to remember, when they designed that 372 crank at 36 millimeter, they did not intend that to do anything else but its job. And it did it very, very well. Well, okay, we're getting crazy and going 2 millimeter longer stroke. We're going to have a lot more torque than that crank was intended. So we're looking at the clutch side of the crank has a possibility of breaking off. That's not where I worry about the most. If I don't get this piston down to around 100 grams, even lighter would be nice, I won't sacrifice strength. That's going to be heavy. That's going to be real heavy. Okay? That could break that rod. But, so we're putting, let's call it 3/4 more stress on it than what it was designed for. I mean, so if you're at 5.5 horse, let's say we get 8-9 horse out of this thing, which is well within the realm as a work saw and still be reliable. Okay, so there's that to consider. And I'm giving you everything that you have. Okay, I don't know what's going on in my video, so I had to restart that. I'm trying to give you everything interesting that you need to know as I think about it, because it's a complex build. It really is. Okay, so now what I got to do is get the cylinder where it fits the body of the saw, ensure I have a crankshaft that's valid for 38 millimeters, before I split the saw. This is what I want. And so this is what we'll be working on today. This is really, really interesting stuff for me, guys. It really is. I can't wait to show you everything there is completely about this. I just can't wait. You're gonna be shocked. But we have to think about the stresses and the strengths. I'm a little worried about that. As an 86cc saw, 55 millimeter bore, 390 cylinder, do what I tell you. I think you're gonna find out it works out fairly well. Other than it sticks to the through the hood a little bit. You can use an X-Torque top cover and hide that if you don't want nobody to know. Or you can do like I did here.